Hi teachers, I think this is a fantastic to annotate on PDF topics. What is the need of annotation of a PDF document? For example, in this document, if I wanted to highlight a particular area for students, that is possible. For example, if I want to highlight this area for students, this particular area for students showing here, you just watch here. I can use the drawing tool to draw a circle here. Okay, and this is fantastic, no? Then there are so many other ways to mark and highlight these areas. There is another tool, that is this particular tool. Okay, yeah, we can highlight this much area, underline. Or we can, instead underline, we can use a highlighter. Important thing that we can add some comments here. Please note. In that way, we can add some comments. It is a free option. And this platform now is a free option. If we purchase it, there is an additional option for voice typing, but if you click now, it will try for start free trial, or we have to purchase it. Then we can add voice comment to that particular area. This may be used by an ordinary teacher to give notes in PDF forms or Word document. Any files can be uploaded here. Any document file, any image file can be uploaded here. We can mark different shapes also here. There are many different shapes. See, math teachers or science teachers, etc., can also utilize these platforms. Okay, then in that way we can highlight or we can erase. There are erase tools are there. So these type of tools are available in many boards, Jamboard like boards. But here the advantage is that we can upload a document file. That is the advantage here. See, if I want to locate this, not this picture, in that way I can add some comments. This is the use by a school teacher. Okay, in college or university, teachers can use this in reverse. The student can submit their proposals, their papers, research papers in this platform, and the teacher can comment in the same way, because there is an option to collaborate. We can share this document. Simply we can share this document, and anyone with the link can annotate. In that way we can sit. Otherwise we can add collaborators. Then only collaborators can annotate that. In that way, that guide and the student relationship. The research student can submit the document in this way, and the teacher can annotate. This can also be, accessed by mobile phones. And what is the advantage is that, and in this presentation, I don't told this name. Its name is Kami. And all the details of Kami is available in blog.kamiapp.com. It also provide a cloud storage where we can share the file. Okay. There is an extension of Google Chrome is available for Kami. If we install that extension, we can directly access the Kami from the Chrome browser, and we can work on that. And in that way, we can utilize this. There are so many other options. Some of the options are locked, and locked means only purchase option is available for that purpose. We can directly type text boxes here. That is, it's in a PDF file itself. We can type. Okay, we can add a heading here inside the picture. In that way, we can make, and after that we can save, or we can upload. We can save, actually it is already uploaded to Kami Cloud, or we can upload to our Google Drive, or we can download. With all this annotation, we can download. If we like to add our voice, we have to purchase. If that feature is also free for teachers, I think it is a fantastic tool for teachers to take the class, because they can upload the PowerPoint in PDF form or any form to upload, and we can conduct classes here. And how to start with this application, I will explain. Okay, then before that, I will close all these windows to start the demonstration of this particular application. Okay, right here in a new window, I think I can start with. The easiest way is to go for Chrome Web Store web plugins. Just search for Chrome web plugin. Okay, in the list of plugin, just search for Kami. Actually, Kami is not owned by this what is called Kami. Kami is not owned by the Google, but yet I think Google support this particular extension, KamiHQ.com, a company, and so many rating is there, so many high rating is there. Okay, it's a PDF and a document annotation platform, but yet we can add, we can use it as a blackboard also. If we upload a blank file, we can annotate directly as a whiteboard. Okay, then click on this to install this. It is already installed. To install, click on this add to Chrome button for in the area, and it will be appeared here. Then click on that Kami application. It will lead you to the particular site. Here we have to create an account, either with the Google itself, or you can create any email ID. Here I already created the account, and using that account I reached here. Then we can open the file from different locations. Okay, we can either upload a file from computer, that is already you watched in the case of that particular PDF file, or you can upload a file, open a file from Google Drive, or you can create a blank new page. Here you can directly type, and you can add materials, add comments, add annotations there in a collaborative way. But because we can share it, you know, we can share the blank file, and we can create this blank page lined or grid, or okay, music sheet, in that different types are there. I take a blank page. How many pages you need, that is that can be added. I hereby added only one page. Now this is the page. Here we can add all these things. We can directly start typing. Dear students, discuss a research problem here. What is advantage is that students can type their idea by sharing collaboratively. This file is not uploaded. Save to Drive. Okay, what is the way to upload? There are two ways. Either you can directly upload to Google Drive, or you can use the file in our error when uploading Drive, and this is trying to upload to what is called Google Drive, but I think it is better to upload to Kami Cloud synchronization, because Kami have its own cloud space, so we can utilize that space. Okay, otherwise we have to permit our Google credentials, email ID and password to this particular application to upload that. Actually, it's a part of Google, but it is safe to use its own cloud space than to use our Google Drive space. Okay, that means it's already uploaded. It's already synchronized. See, not yet. Not yet. Here we have to synchronize. I think it may take some time. Otherwise, I can upload. Actually, it is already saved. Last saved in 2 minutes ago, isn't it? So there is no problem with. We can work on this. Okay. Then we can add a drawing here. We can start creating a concept map in this way, a rough concept map, and ask students to fill the data in it. And this is one of the way to use this particular platform. Otherwise, we can use in another way. Okay, I think now I can share this file. For that purpose, I want to, uploading. Upload to get link. Yeah, it is uploaded. It is uploaded now. Now click on this link. Yeah, and send this link via email or WhatsApp to our student. Then what the student can observe is that if student try to open in his or her mobile phone or mobile browser, or there is no mobile application, so we can open in mobile browser. Then otherwise they open in a laptop. After a time it will open in their laptop, but here they have to create an email ID to edit it. Okay, here other with the email, the same email I can use. Otherwise the student can use his or her Google ID to open this application and can start typing there, and this is the method to work on it. And there is another option. We can upload a file from my computer. We can upload different types of files. Even an image can be uploaded. The file conversion, okay, it may be converted into a PDF style file, and on that file we can work. So there is no limitations of the type of file. I think that file is now converted into, then there are so many options. It automatically recognizes the text on this document that they ask whether it is needed to run on OCR. Okay, now I click on no, because there is no OCR. Then now here I can add again some highlighters here. In that way we can highlight a particular area of the image. Okay, that is, there are different way of working together in a collaborative way between the teacher and the students, and the teacher can utilize if uploaded another material, like for example, if it is uploaded a text document for teaching, see this is a paper, a scale of universal something. Okay, a teacher want to explain this paper to the student. Okay, think, and teacher explains the scale of university students' attitude towards learning on the Moodle system. See, some questions are given in the lower area of this paper, and you have to search on that particular part. For that purpose, teacher can highlight in this way. These are the dimensions. Okay. Teacher can comment here. These are the dimensions. Please pass through. Okay, in that way teacher can
comment on that particular area, and the student can notice that areas. Okay, in that different way, we can utilize this for LKG students to PhD students. We can utilize this platform. Okay, thank you for watching.